Hello, I'm Paul Stankard at Salem Community College's Samuel H. Jones Glass Education Center, where we hold the annual International Flameworking Conference. Since 2001, master artists from around the globe have demonstrated their talent here in the spirit of sharing with our students and conference attendees. We recorded these demonstrations so students and glass enthusiasts can be inspired by these featured artists. This collection of video demonstrations is now being offered to you through Salem Community College's exclusive Master's Series. Cesare Toffolo comes from a family of well-known master glassmakers in Murano, Italy. Both his father and grandfather were skilled artisans. Cesare began learning the fundamentals of lamp working at the age of 14, and he is passing on his family traditions by teaching glassmaking to his sons. With his inventive spirit and his own avant-garde technique, Cesare creates artistic glass celebrating beauty, and many of his pieces are internationally exhibited in museums and galleries. Since 1991, Cesare has been a sought-after instructor at glass schools around the world. His highly skilled techniques and beautiful forms comprise the technical standards by which other flame working is measured. Let's watch Cesare Toffolo as he demonstrates at the 2004 International Flameworking Conference.
So Cesare is going to start now, and he's going to do, at the very beginning, he's going to be preparation work. He's going to pull what we call the point. In Italy, we call them the file. So he's going to pull the various points to prepare for the object that he's going to make. He's going to make in the United States, we call it a Venetian goblet. But in Italy, diciamo un tippetto, no? In Italy, in Venice, in particular Venice, we call it tippetto. It's a particular name that we give to that particular goblet, like the one that he has out there in the case. And it's gonna be made out of what we call the cup. In Venetian, we call it made out of mezza filigrana or F filigree. So, and it's gonna pick up the various little canes for the filigree from that optic mold that he has preheated. Posso dire questo che ci devo fare?
Sì.
As you notice, Cesare is not cutting the tubing in half. He's just pulling a point directly from the very end of the tube, so he made the best use of the entire length of the tube. And that comes directly from his early learning in production making, where he has to buy his own tubing, and he couldn't waste a single centimeter of it. Spussa un fia, però no, va bene stesso. As you see, he doesn't use any cutting tools. He used the diamond shear just to break the point, and then he fire polish it and make it flat with the back of the tweezers. A little bit different from what we do here. Thank you. bravissimo. Adesso chi parla mi sposta il telefono. Cesare, before he started, he was afraid that this part that he's doing now would be a little bit boring for a knowledgeable public like you, but I think we all have to learn even from the movement that he does pull, for doing just a simple pull point that for him is so natural and for us is so difficult. Now he's pulling some points for the stem. Part of the stem is going to be hollow, part of it. He brought with him a few set of flowers that are preheating in the kiln, because it would have taken him a couple hours just to make those flowers setups. So he pre-prepared some flowers with leaves around it, and they're preheating. And then they will go; those flowers will go in the middle of the stem. And part of the tubing that he's pulling now, points that he's pulling now for the stem, will be encased with gold. So you will have the pleasure and the to see him doing the gold leafing on a tube. Cos'è Teresa? Ah, solo me. Cosa ti fa?
Intanto la canna un po' più grossa per girare a pigra.
Sì.
Se no, qui se riesco a massa presto. Questa fila. Un po' più affina vado meglio a girare.
Sì. Sì, anche a me non riesco a farla. Anche a me dopo 6-7 mm. Non riesco a girare con quella grossa.
È un ragazzo al punto più affinato.
Again, what he's doing is all preparation. He's using for turning the mezza filigrana that he's gonna do pick up in a few minutes. He's gonna use a rod of glass, and he feels very much at ease, much more at ease using 6 millimeters. But if he were to use 6 millimeters for turning. The flame would melt it too quickly, so at the very end, you just attach a piece of a thicker rod at the end of the 6 millimeters. And now he's preparing the gather of glass for the pickup for the mezza filigrana.
Posso tutta filigrana? Comunque, sì. Adesso mi faccio questo dopo andrò a saperlo dentro. Questo dovrebbe essere più caldo.
Sì, adesso che spero.
Vada tutto bene. In qualche modo fermo.
He wants you to know that he's gonna pick up those little rods that he has pre-prepared there inside the optic mold on a hot plate. He's afraid that the hot plate is not hot enough. When you go inside with the gather of glass to pick them up, the rods needs to be hot so they stick on the gather of glass, on the bubble of glass. If they are cold, sometimes they come off before you go in, back into the flame, or right after you go into the flame. So he's apologizing if one of those is gonna come off, but he said one way or another one, we're gonna fix it up, because he has an extra little rod that he prepared. Usually when he does it at this house, he said, they are much, much harder. They are twice as hard as they have them here. So he asks for forgiveness. Aiuto, gli ho detto che per piacere di scusarlo se qualcosa va, si è messo a ridere perché gli pare impossibile. And now he's shaping the bubble into more conical shape so he can go inside the optic mold with the right shape. Ti dispiace se che parlo della fornasa, di tutto quello che ti ha portati della fornasa? As you can see, those movements, they are very unusual for the lamp workers in the United States that does blown objects. They were developed by Cesare, only by him. Nobody used to do it before him. What he did, he took, like he said yesterday, all the technique of the glass factory, and he imported them into the lamp working and the glass blowing. That's why he's marveling on the top of the graphite, and he's doing the same identical procedure that you would do if you were making this object at a glass factory. That's why he's doing this. He also prefers to use little canes separated equally inside, equally separated inside that optic mold, because when you pick them up, they all have the same thickness and all have the same distance to each other. Differently from what we normally do in this country, that we strike the glass with the rod. Resta solo una. Una sua. Yeah, una sua. See, he's having some difficulties because they're cold. Usually if the little rods, the stringers are hot enough, they stick to it. And one is still inside the mold, so he has to pick it up and reattach it. But he said no problem, he's gonna put it back again.
No, ma a me ti dico, va bene fin adesso, non voglio disturbarlo.
È una lavora perfetta perché si è mosso il fianco.
Si è mosso un fianco?
Sì, in attacco.
Ok. He's apologizing again because when he picked them up, they were too cold. So when he went to the flame, a couple of the stringers moved a little bit, so they're not equally distanced from each other. So he apologized if there's no absolutely perfect.
Quindi adesso sta qua, prepara, la metto qua. e probabilmente la userò per fare il pier, che ora che ne tolgo metà.
E ti che ne fa un'altra?
Faccio un'altra, che sarebbe bene.
So, he was planning to use this one for the cup of the piece, but since it's not as perfect as he wanted, he's gonna finish it on and then put it on the side and use this one for the foot and make another one for the cup. Hopefully is gonna be better than this one. But he hopes at least that it's gonna be better than this one because the little stringers are too cold. And again, you will see that he used straight furnace work that he imported from there into the lamp working world. Senfia scomodo.
penso di sì, perché se la sposta, speriamo che sta trovando ancora meglio, o bevante. Perché sapevo che massa fredda. Però è la prima volta che mi succede. Qua di solito che dico, sa, il fornetto e di solito la temperatura va bene. Però sto qua l'ho visto subito che c'era. Va bene, normale, si va
male, non è male, non è male. I was going to prepare the other little rods for the pickup. To l'acqua?
No, no.
Okay. He's trying to choose the thinner one so they get hot much faster. Usually he used a little bit thicker one, but he's getting the thinner, the thinnest one. So hopefully they're going to be a little bit hotter when he picks them up.
Giulio, what is the color?
The color, Curtis, che dopo?
Hardware,
tipo di dopo è bianco e blu, no?
Sì, quasi.
He's using, right now he's using hardware color, the little bars that he pulls in stringers, because they are very good opalescent colors for his work. Well, he said for the filigrana, he uses hardware colors, the little bars. Then for the flowers, you will see he uses other colors. Some is glass alchemy, some is North Star.
Quasi so, sempre, quasi sempre fatto.
But,
questi che adesso sei dentro, sono sempre fatto questi colori.
Yeah. Qui, yeah. Anche qui dentro, eh?
Questi che sei dentro.
Anche il verde trasparente.
Esempio, il verde trasparente.
No, quello no.
Il cecoslovacco.
Adesso, yeah. Ma vuoi dire qui o no? No, perché la domanda. Yeah, and the flowers that you will see coming out later, those particular flowers, he still made them with aardvark colors, except for the green leaves. There is a new green that comes from Czechoslovakia that when you work it, is a light transparent green. Even when you work it with the reducing flame, he said, it doesn't reduce, it stays green. So that's why he uses that green for the leaves. But usually when he does those filigrana opaque, it's aardvark, the little bars. Any other question while he's preparing? Quanto sei col tubo? Non mi ricordo più.
Sei 40.
40 per 2 mesi.
2
e 3. 40 per 2 e 3 è stato ad essere.
Ah,
per,
20,
sì, ma ti dopo sempre 2, 2 e 3, non ti dopo mai.
Sì, sì.
The one that is using, that he used for to make the pickup, is a 40 millimeters by, oh, the question is what kind of diameter and thickness is using? What kind of thickness and diameter? That tube is a 40 millimeters by 2.3, 2.4, and the other one is, quanto si sta altro? 22, 22 by 1.8, yeah, 1.8, 22 by 1.8. And he also said, I asked him, he also said that he always used those kind of wall thickness. He never used a heavier than 2.5 to that's kind of wall thickness.
Sì, il durance, diciamo, per diametri, per spessori, è molto meno, però è verde.
Adesso.
Va bene se ti va a fare dei robe colate, però se ti va a fare cristallo, non fermarsi.
Grazie. Okay, the question is, what kind of tube, what kind of brand of tube he usually uses? He said many years ago he used to use the one made in France, but now perché ne produce più in Francia adesso. The one in France, the big plant in France that used to produce Pyrex made in France, is not operational anymore. So he mostly uses Duran that is made by Schott. But the problem with Duran that he found is that Duran is
perfect in diameter, he said, perfect in thickness, but it's a little bit greenish. So when he wants to make a perfectly clear object, he prefers other kinds. What kind? He said it's tough to find a kind that is very, very nice and clean, but that blows well, that is very uniform in wall thickness and in diameter. So what he ends up is that he has to try. Every now and then you get one company, the other company, but mostly he uses Duran for the pickup color. So even if it is greenish, he covers them with color. And other kinds, altri tipi cosa può essere? Kimball?
Or Kimball,
Kimball and Simax. That's what he uses for the perfectly clear. Si è scaldato. Si è appena tiepida, amore. Sì,
freddo.
Oh. He's complaining it's still a little bit too cold. So he's afraid that neither this one is gonna come out the way he wants to. Ognuno fuori bene? Sei contento? Yeah, he's happy, so we needed a good one. E tu va bene? Good. He's just cleaning it because he uses this torch. This is a Herbert Arnold from Germany, torch from Germany. That's his everyday torch. But this is the propane one. And he uses this only when he goes around teaching and doing demonstrations. So the little tools that he has on the side that he rolls on is basically a surrogate for the jacks. So, since it's got an arm that is too long, if you try to hold it with one hand and using the jacks with the other and clamp it down, it would move too much. So you put that blade on the side and it rolls on the blade and it does the same thing that you would do on a glass factory with the jacks. But again, since he used this torch not every day, it got rusted and he didn't want any metal mark on his piece. Thank you.
the one on top of the torch. Fa la voglia. Okay. Perché domandasse di solito su ama e altri che metti cera o no? Yeah, usually wax it when it works. Like you do for the jack's blades.
Tanto viene da me, se acciarà. Avete questa categoria, no? Sì, parlo. Poi ha un carattere, cioè si era informata.
No, davvero?
Cioè, e ora è vanta la mia. Che cosa? E se fortissimo.
Anche non ti avevo
visto. Sì, sì, certo. Sicuramente.
Così non fa parlare.
Cosa? Stava qua? Passo il Gianfilico.
What he's doing now is preparing the inside color for what we call the zanfirico cane. It's basically the what you call the ribbon cane. So he's going to encase this with clear. So he put again. He used the same color. He used white and blue, attached together. Squeeze them. Put this is a blue scuro over there on the fianco. No. Put a thread of black all the way around. Now it's going to encase it, then pull it and twist it, and use that for the stem, to shape the stem.
fisso ormai. Ah? Ormai è già fisso. No, non so niente. Parlo dopo.
He usually covers the color with 12 millimeters rod, but he didn't have it around, so he's using 10 now. So he said he's gonna work anyway. He's gonna make it work anyway. Scusi me, non sapevo. No, sei colpa mia. But you notice the care that he's using on every single move that he does, on every single thing that he's preparing, and every single movement is planned. Nothing is left to the accident or up the accident. Everything is pre-planned, everything is pre-thought, everything is has been tried thousands and thousands of times. So even for me, that I'm a glass maker, a glass blower, it's always a treat to see Cesare working, because I always learn something new from what he's doing. I always see new things that I didn't notice a year ago or a month ago or whenever I saw him last time. And I also see the difference that in his way of doing things and my way or other people's ways of doing things. So I also would like for you to always focus on how he handles the glass, how he's using the glass, and the way that he's not abusing it, but being a friend with it. That comes from years and years and years and years of practice. And naturally, from all the knowledge that has been given to him by the long tradition of the Muranese glass.
come se scaldato ancora il cranio.
Questo qua è foglia d'oro, no?
Foglia d'oro,
no?
Foglia d'oro
muranese. Well, in Murano, he's asking if it is foil or leaf. In Murano we call gold leaf. What is the heavy one? There are different thicknesses. We'll ask him later what. Più te domanda dopo. Qui te tenive domande per dopo. Thank you.
Well, nobody before him figured out how to put gold leaf on Pyrex and work it hot. So there you are. Seems easy now that you saw it. But it's difficult to do it, although it's still difficult to do it. But as he explained on the slides last night, when he pointed out of the gold ball on the gold sphere on his goblets, he tried and retried and tried and retried for many years. And he finally figured it out how to do it all on his own. So Cesare is a glass maker, a glass blower, and a glass artist that revolutionized single-handedly the technique of lamp working, glass blowing on the torch. He did it all on his own. He figured it out all on his own. He was on very solid basis, thanks to his father, his grandfather, and the tradition where he comes from. But we have many more thousands, hundreds, or even thousands of other lamp workers and glassware in Murano, and they're still there. Cesare is the only one that moved ahead with the technique. And we all learn from him, and we're still all learning from him. Scusa? Oh, yes, and my wife points out that he's also very, very generous in showing to everybody those techniques that he developed. So it's very humble on it. Vuoi sapere cosa che ho detto? Beh.
is preparing the avolio, part of the avolio on one side of the golden blown stem. He's gonna attach a thread on it. Now notice how he does it. That's another thing that the cui ti assi cascar dritto e ti giri il fer. Now notice how he does it. That's another thing that he figured out on his own, to put a piece of thread of glass on the circumference. Watch. Ah. No problem. He said propane is much hotter than natural gas, so it needs to adjust a little bit to the kind of flame, so he wasn't expecting that much heat. But that's how, again, he invented this way, to put it exactly in around the circumference, all uniform. So that's another of his inventions. Again, it seems easy now that you see it, but before Cesare, there was nothing. Now he's gonna save it in the kiln.
Now you guys can understand why he brought those flowers already made to put in this goblet.
Questi cominci a mettere assieme, no? E va bene, non importa. Now it's gonna start assembling the entire stem. C'è il Molise, vedete Molise. He's applying what we in Venetian we call Molise, Molise. Sometimes they call it in this country Molise, and he's using a blue color that he pre-prepared, and the way he does it to make it look more like almost exactly like Fornasuor blue. He pre-prepared those rods. He took a clear rod and he encased it with cobalt blue and then stretched it. So they're much lighter color. And sometimes even mixes other color together to get much, much closer to the color that we use in the glass factory to get the same effect. That's what he does. While he's doing this and you're noticing what he's doing with the torch and putting those very fine details on the stem, I want to tell you something that about the history of glass that relates directly to this, to what he's doing. There are some documents and our dear friend Burkill read those documents as well. In the Medici in Florence, the Medici used to have a glass factory in their Boboli garden in Florence. And they set up this glass factory and they hired Venetian, Muranese people and Venetian people to work there. In one of those documents, there are various documents and various letters about those things, and they were making blown objects, Venetians blown objects, particularly goblets, with very elaborate stems. The master that they hired was a very good master, but his uncle, if I remember, in one of those letters, says that his uncle was much better. So the Medici hired his uncle as well, and they called him to come from Venice or Murano to Florence to make more elaborate objects. In the meantime, while they were waiting for him to travel from Venice to Florence, there is a letter that says, in the meantime, while we're waiting for him to come, we're gonna finish the stems of the goblets at the lamp. So it means that they were also doing some extra work on the stem at the lamp. So they were applying lamp working on the stem of those Venetian goblet made at the furnace, and it's well documented. If you ask, I don't remember where, which book they're reproduced, it slips my mind, but I can't remember now. Maybe Fred will, with his powerful mind, will remember, but later on you can ask Fred Burkill there. So it's not that we are doing, Cesare is doing something that that in Murano, well, let's make an observation. In Murano, many people, when Cesare started doing those beautiful Venetian objects at the torch, they said, well, it's sort of like cheating some of the Venetian master that didn't have enough open mind, because you're doing everything on the torch and you can do get more details, you can do extra things, but they were ignorant of the fact that those things were done, a mixture between glass blowing and lamp working, were done centuries ago. So if they had studied and if they had done their homework before, they would have not insulted Cesare, and they would not have a look at him with the chip on their shoulder and say, oh yes, but it's lamp working. So, and again, one thing that Cesare is doing through his object is re-elevating. And he did it again at the beginning by himself, and now we are all following him on his wake, re-elevating the lamp working process to a higher status. I mean, him with this kind of work, mostly reproduction of Venetian goblets and little chandeliers and his own personal work. Christina Logan with starting with simple beads and going to sculpture objects that you can wear. Robert Mickelson, Shane Farrow, and every other person that more or less in this room more or less contributed to that. And Paul Stanker. Yeah, well, man. He's apologizing if he's taking so long because he thought we already started half an hour late because we had a problem with the gas line, and but it should be done shortly in 20 minutes. So, but you understand, he has to take his time to finish the piece properly. So. Per dirti che ti va di va, praticamente. I know we have the curator and director of the museum waiting for us to do the, was supposed to start at 11, but glass is an unpredictable material, and if you want to make a nice object, but it's almost done, it's almost through. He's going to put the flowers on. Then open. And you all know if you rush, him, maybe he's gonna make a mistake and makes no sense to. Okay, the news is that he's gonna finish, he finished the stem, he's gonna finish the cup, he's gonna open the cup, and then he's gonna put it away, or leave it there, and we're gonna go ahead with the rest of the program, and the foot is gonna be done this evening, instead of finishes, what is 3:15 they were supposed to finish today, we're gonna come back here, he's gonna make the foot, and we're gonna put everything together. Is that okay? Because, yeah, okay. So let's see him watching. Let's watch him finishing the top part.
Meio isso.
Now, this is another thing that he developed by himself. He comes directly from furnace work, using the diamond shears, using the jacks. But look how he opens the top, holding it vertical. Very unusual. And again, easy to see, to know and out and figure it out now that you saw him doing it. There you are, the perfect cup. He always amazes me, they always come out right, these cups. And again, the vertical. Another thing that he came out, another technique that he developed. And graphite jacks, so you can put the jacks in the flame. They don't get, they don't lose the wax like the other jacks, and he can go back and forth in the flame as many times as he wants.
And also a special appreciation to the team.